obviously you know Ben very well. What do you think he's going to bring to the role of Jesus?
Oh, God, apart from absolute raw talent, he's just so passionate about it. So I think it's going to be really genuine, and everything he's going to do is just going to seem so heartfelt and honest. And everybody knows him now, so he's got personality as well. So yeah, that.
This is clearly a big move for the show coming into a venue like this. What do you think that's going to add to the production that people won't have seen from the theatre?
Well, it's just going to be so much space and so much more people are actually going to get to see it. And I think arenas appeal to just a bigger audience. So whether you're old, young, I think you're just going to hear about it, especially the fact that it's been on a TV show first. So much more people are going to want to come and see it and support it. And it's got so much space. It's just going to be a raw atmosphere. I think it's just going to be electric, really. Obviously, the theatre is amazing, but coming to an arena, it's so lively. So it's going to be great. It's going to be really good.
Clearly, the competition benefited Ben, but there is a bit of a debate about whether these shows are helping or hindering young talent getting into the West End. I mean, how do you feel about that?
I think it's difficult to say, really. I mean, I think any opportunity where, if you're talented, you can showcase what you want to do, I think it's a great platform. Obviously, some shows don't always show the best of talent, but a show like this really does. I mean, so many of the contestants have been in musicals before and have trained for such a long time. So I think it was just another platform for people to you know, achieve their dream, really. So I was a great supporter of this show.
What are you working on yourself at the moment?
I'm filming a film in Paris called Black Girl in Paris by Shay Youngwood. And I've come down this week and it's raining here and it's sunny in Paris. But yes, that's what I'm doing at the moment.
Can you tell us anything about that? Who you're playing in that?
I play a lady called Luce. And it's a story about a young girl who goes to Paris to kind of find herself. And she finds another lady and they embark on a huge journey together. So it's been tiring but great, really exciting.
Who else are you in that with?
Myself and a lady called Tracy Higgins. She's a wonderful actress. She just has done Twilight. So she's very, very busy. So she's kind of doing the PR over there and coming back to Paris. So, yeah, she's lovely.
You a Twilight fan yourself? Were you chatting to her a lot about that?
Well, I tried not to. I tried to, you know, be not as geeky as I wanted to be. But we've been filming a while now, so I've managed to ask her some really geeky questions. So, yeah, she doesn't mind.
What kind of geeky stuff? You're obviously a Twihard yourself. So what kind of Twilight stuff were you chatting to her about?
I just asked her, obviously I've read the book, so I just asked her what it's like to film on the set, what's it like working with the director, what the other cast members like, and I think because she gets asked all those questions all the time, she was a bit blasé, and I was like, no, detail, what are the costumes like, how many hours a day do you film, how's this person, how's that person, yeah, all the questions you could possibly think of, basically.
What was the best answer you got out of her, the most juicy thing that you found out?
Oh, God, what is the most juicy thing? Nothing really. It always happens that you try and ask a juicy question and it's just really, really calm and civil and I'm not sure. Everything's just kind of how I expected it to be. Everyone gets on really well and that's it really.